This is the Sabercat Report with Saguaro Sabercat football coach Jason Mons on the Varsity Sports Show, AM 1060 KDUS Arizona. And now, here's Coach Mons.
Welcome back to the Varsity Sports Show here on AM 1060 KDUS Arizona. And when you hear that intro, it is none other than the Sabercat Report with Saguaro High School head football coach Jason Mons. Let's go to Coach Mons. Good morning, Coach Mons. How are you, sir?
I'm good, Vince. How you doing?
I'm all right. We're a little off kilter today, but we're getting there and adapt and overcome. Coach, man, I'll tell you what, I like that intro. Way to pick it. We let you pick the intro song, and I'm an old rock and roll guy, but I stray a little bit. I like all music, and that sounds like there's a little bit of a theme in there about winning.
Yeah, you know, we like to win. We're competitors here, and that song gets me going. I think you got to have that mindset, show up every day, and everything you got to do is got to be putting you in that direction towards winning ball games. So that's why that's why I chose that one. I like it. I'm not gonna lie, it got me a little fired up while I was waiting for the show to start here.
I'll say, and then that voiceover guy, you know who that is?
No, who was that?
It's your basketball coach.
Oh man, he's got a face for radio, that's for sure.
He does. You know what? That's what I tell him that all the time, and so I think he's tired of hearing it. But he's, you know, Coach Lucas Ramirez out there. He does a little voiceover work for us, so he's pretty good. So anybody that if that coaching thing doesn't work out for him, the late Bruce Snyder used to tell us, there's two kinds of coaches, and everybody says it. You know, those that have been fired and those that are going to be fired, unfortunately.
No doubt.
So,
no doubt.
Anyway. All right, Coach, let's get into talking about your team. So I am sky high because this week we're starting off our coverage of Saguaro High School football. We spent a little time with you throughout the offseason here and there and kind of watching this team gel and develop. Man, you guys have some firepower. You got weapons. You got a great staff. You got a great administration. I want to start with this, and I know opinions are opinions, but this high school football America preseason number 5 West Coast. How did all this come about? These guys, these guys have been covering you for a while here, but wow.
Yeah, just saw that. Definitely honored. They do a great job, high school football America, I don't know. They know much more about who's who and who's got what coming back across the country than I do.
Yeah.
Obviously, anytime that you're held in that kind of regard, preseason, it means that you've got a lot of potential. I think for us right now, we're more focused on trying to be in that conversation postseason. So we're not really trying to talk. I didn't even retweet it, to be honest with you, because. I think we're at a point now, which is, we want to be more substance than hype, and we're just focused on what we need to do it day in and day out. So, definitely honored that we were mentioned there. It's when you look at the other teams that are in that top five, it's an incredible honor to be talked with. But we want to be mentioned amongst those teams at the end of the season, not the beginning of it.
Well, I have to admit, Coach, I retweeted it. So anyway, even though you didn't, I did. But I have to say, okay, so then let's ignore the fact that you're preseason number 1 in 5A. We're just going to ignore that one. We'll glaze over that one and move on and start talking about your team. So I'm really excited because I know a few of these young men, had a chance to cover them during baseball season. Your team captains this year, you named, and basketball season as well. You got some multi-sport athletes. Let's talk about these guys. You got Javon Jacobs, Ridge Dosakal, Cannon Siegel, who I haven't met yet, but I look forward to meeting him, a linebacker. Tommy DeCesaro, a baseball player. Parker Brailsford, I had a chance to interview him last year. Great young man, offensive lineman. And then, of course, what can you say about the man in the middle on the basketball team, Tristan Monday? I mean, talk about each of those guys.
Yeah, no, I think, when we talk about picking captains for Saguaro, I really challenge our guys to look at, who puts the program above themselves and who represents Saguaro football and what we're all about in everything they do on the field, off the field, in the classroom, in the community. That's really important to us. And I think our kids nailed it this year. I mean, we got four dudes that bleed black and gold. They're competitors. They care about the program. You know, all extremely talented individual players in multiple sports. But they're all guys that have sold out for trying to help us achieve our goal. And so I was really proud of our team. I think they picked the tremendous leaders, and you know, they got it pretty spot on. There's maybe one or two other guys that I think could have been up in that group, but you know, we always vote for six. We have three that are kind of steady every week, and then we kind of rotate the fourth captain between the other three guys, but all will be counted on for leadership roles. Like you mentioned, a couple multi-sport guys there. Tommy Deitch, Chez, as we like to call him, the Chessero, is yeah. A baseball stud, you know, ace pitcher, plays in the field, move him all around. He's just the dude's just an athlete. He's a competitor. You know, it's just one of those guys where he's not the tallest, he's not the fastest, he's not the strongest, but he's going to outwork you. He's going to outsmart you. He's going to outwant you. He gives us everything he's got, and he's a tremendous leader. He's a tremendous ball player. He's a playmaker. He's one of those guys. He just always finds himself around the football. And I know it was the same thing, you know, for Coach Mickey on the baseball field. He was a leader for them last year as a junior. He was their ace pitcher, and he's just a dude that's going to help you win games. It doesn't matter what sport you're playing.
Well, again, you guys got to be the poster child for multi-sport athletes and still having success. So coaches out there, let these kids play other sports, because this is a prime example where coaches work together of other sports. You Coach Mickey get along. Obviously, we kid Coach Ramirez. You got a great AD in Matt Harris. I mean, all you guys get along great. You guys share the same pool of student athletes. And it works. I mean, this is a prime example. It works. And with these guys playing multi-sport, and they're being recruited in other sports as well. And that's the thing that just gets me, is that they excel in any shape ball that they touch. They're excelling. I mean, talk about Tristan playing basketball, for gosh sakes.
Absolutely. Yeah. And just to touch on what we talked about, I mean, obviously, you know, Lucas came in, took over the basketball program last year, embraced the football culture and, you know, really was welcoming and flexible with those guys. And he gets it. He's been around football. He's been an assistant coach before in football. So he understands it. And I think last year, six of the 12 kids that were on the varsity basketball roster were football guys in the fall. So, and they had great success. They won a region in the first year, a major turnaround, that program is trending big time in the right direction. So, and Joe Mickey, you know, and I have been together for a long time here at Saguaro. We've always worked together. We had a bunch of kids. I took my son to watch their playoff game against Seton last year, and I think it was five or six of the nine that were on the field to start that game were football kids. So, you know, we take great pride in that, and that's what, to me, is what makes Saguaro so special and so unique, is we have big-time athletic programs here. But we don't strong arm kids into having to specialize and only pick one sport. We really promote multi-sport athletes. We embrace it. We take pride in it, and coaches work together. You know, we build our summer schedules and routines around what the other guys are doing. And, you know, obviously work closely with Lucas, and kids will get on the field in the morning, and then they'll go lift, and they'll go get lunch, and they'll come back and be able to get on the court and do some stuff. And then he knows too, hey, we had a hard conditioning day. So, you know, he's not going to run them as hard, 'cause they might have a 7-on-7 later. So just that communication relationship has been huge. It's made it where kids want to do it, because when coaches embrace it and work together, every school is going to say that they allow it. But it's one thing to allow it. It's another thing to embrace it and to work together to do it the right way. So, you know, credit to the other guys, you know, for being willing to do that. Back to Tristan. I mean, Tristan is he is a physical presence on the field and the court. I truly enjoyed watching him play basketball this year, and taking some of the chip on his shoulder and aggression that he plays with on the football field and putting it on the court. And there wasn't a lot of guys in the paint that wanted to get in front of him. And you know, he was the guard.
No.
He cleaned
no.
up the boards, and he got a lot of scrappy, you know, physical points in the paint. And I thought was a huge part of the success that they had. So, you know, we love to see that. It's fun. I mean, I take my kids. I mean, we go and watch volleyball games, and got a great relationship with Coach Church, our volleyball coach. And, you know, go watch the basketball games, go out to baseball games. It's what makes high school football and the community that we have here, high school athletics, you know, so special.
I'd like to bring on, and one thing we're going to do differently this year is we'll have guest color commentary week in, week out. You'll have faculty, you'll have former players that'll join us up in the box to offer their insights. And so we look forward to doing that moving forward. This week, we're at McClintock for the opening game. Looking forward to covering Coach Corbin Smith's team with the Chargers and your whole or your opener on the season. It's an away game, but doing color commentary for us this week is a young man who helped us with baseball this past season, Ryan Sikora, who is a Walter Cronkite student out at ASU. Ryan, good morning, sir.
Good morning, Vince.
Hello.
Good morning, Coach.
There he is. All right. All right. So, Ryan, we got a big game this week. Coach, really quickly, tell us a little bit about what you've seen on film with McClintock.
Yeah, you know, actually, we've been in the office this morning watching them exchange a couple games from last year and then the scrimmage film. We just completed our scrimmage Thursday, so we got that traded up. So, yeah, you know, I think they do a great job. Corbin is not only a really good dude, but he's a good football coach. Their kids play hard. They run to the ball. They're disciplined. And so, you know, I know they had some juice, some dynamic players that they had to replace. But you saw some guys making plays in the scrimmage. And the one thing I know is that they're going to be physical. They're going to be well coached, and they're going to play hard.
All right. Well, folks, that'll be the first of many Sabercat reports this season with head football coach Jason Monsuaro, Sabercats. Coach, good luck this week. Look forward to catching up with you in pregame. And it's going to be a heck of a season. It's going to be a lot of work, but I'm up for it. I know we all are, and you and your coaches are going to do a great job as always. So thanks again, Coach Mons. We'll see you this week.
All right, guys. Appreciate you.
All right. Coach Jason Mons. So, Ryan, stay on the line here because I want to talk to you. Are you excited about this season?
100% excited about the season. I mean, you look at all the hype around the program this year, and it's just it's different than the last couple of years in the state where it almost just felt like Chandler and everyone else, and now it just seems like the Sabercats have jumped into the conversation and not only jumped in, but might even just be the best program out there.
Well, yeah, and we're talking 12 state championships and six under Coach Mons as the head coach. I mean, these guys have been in the conversation for a long time, and they will continue to be, and this could very well be the best team that they've ever had out at Saguaro. So, you know, it remains to be seen. You got to go out and play the games, and these kids know that, and these coaches do as well, but these guys are good. They're going to be good, and we are excited that we are a part of it this year. So, Ryan Sikora, color analyst for the Saguaro Sabercats, joining me this week out at McClintock, Friday night, 7 p.m. Varsity Sports Show is now part of the Sabercat team. Athletic Director Matthew Harris, thank you so much. Coach Jason Mons. Mr. Harris, I want to thank him because he helped to orchestrate all of this. He's a great AD, and we look forward to covering them. So anyway, when we come back from the break, we're going to take a step back, and we will be joined for the Beachin' with Beal report. Guys, if you've never heard this thing, stick around, listen through the commercials, and join us. My old high school friend, teammate Mike Beal, it's fun. We have a lot of fun with it, so it'll be a great time. So stick around. We'll be back after the break here on the Varsity Sports Show. Go Varsity!